Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off today's video, we have another Falcon 9 launch as SpaceX launched the OneWeb 16 mission on Monday.
One, engines full power, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go Falcon, go OneWeb 2.
The booster which launched this mission, B1076, then landed successfully for the second time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 1.
Stage 1 FTS is saved.
It's less than a 20-second burn. As you can see, the engines have shut down. That concludes the entry burn for the first stage vehicle.
Both vehicles continue to follow nominal trajectories.
Now we are just about 30 seconds away from the landing burn beginning on the first stage vehicle. It is just the E9 engine that will ignite for landing. And the M1D engines have about 190,000 pounds of thrust. So one engine reigniting is just enough to help slow the vehicle down in time to touch down for landing.
Stage 2, FTS is saved.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There you can see the landing burn has begun on Falcon 9. Let's watch as the first stage touches down on Landing Zone 1.
Landing leg deploy.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Wow, an awesome view of our landing. As you just saw, Falcon 9 has touched down on Landing Zone 1. That marks SpaceX's 162nd recovery of an orbital class rocket.
We were also expecting to see the Starlink 2-4 mission launch earlier today, but SpaceX posted this tweet. They said, standing down from today's launch of Starlink to take a closer look at data from second stage. Teams are setting up for next launch opportunity, which is tomorrow, January 11th at 7:48 p.m. Pacific time. Then earlier today, SpaceX posted another tweet saying, now targeting Saturday, January 14th at 7:06 p.m. Pacific time for launch of Starlink to allow additional time for pre-launch checkouts. So the launch of Starlink 2-4 is now scheduled for a few days from now. The mission is expected to lift off on Sunday 15th at 3:06 a.m. UTC or Saturday 14th at 10:06 p.m. EST. As a reminder, we could hopefully see a Falcon Heavy launch very soon with the launch pushed back slightly. The Falcon Heavy USSF 67 launch is currently scheduled for Saturday 14th at 10:51 p.m. UTC or 5:51 p.m. EST. SpaceX posted a tweet confirming the launch date of the Falcon Heavy mission. They said, full duration static fire of Falcon Heavy complete. Targeting no earlier than Saturday, January 14th for the launch of the USSF 67 mission from Florida. The latest cargo Dragon that went to the ISS returned back to Earth. The ISS posted this tweet saying the SpaceX Dragon cargo ship undocked from the station at 5:05 p.m. Eastern Time today and will return to Earth on Wednesday loaded with several tons of scientific cargo for analysis. Earlier today, SpaceX confirmed successful splashdown of the Cargo Dragon capsule to complete the CRS-26 mission. AirBaltic posted a tweet related to Starlink and their fleet of planes. They said, we have selected SpaceX's Starlink to bring internet connectivity to our Airbus A220-300 fleet. All of our passengers will have access to complimentary high-speed satellite internet on every AirBaltic flight. With the situation on the ISS with the stranded cosmonauts and astronaut, there was an article posted with unofficial information about the plan to return them. The next Soyuz mission, which will be MS-23, will have only one cosmonaut instead of the three it would have had. The two cosmonauts will stay on the station through the duration of the MS-23 mission and return on that capsule. Then the next Crew Dragon mission, which will be Crew 6, will have 3 passengers instead of the planned 4 and they will fly an additional pressure suit. The stranded astronaut will then stay on the ISS for the duration of the Crew 6 mission before returning home with the rest of the Crew 6 crew. There was an article posted about the National Science Foundation and SpaceX working together to mitigate the effects of Starlink on ground-based astronomy. It says SpaceX worked with the US National Science Foundation and its radio astronomy observatories to mitigate potential interference from SpaceX satellite transmissions focusing on the 10.6 to 10.7 GHz radio astronomy band. NSF and SpaceX continue to explore methods to further protect ground-based astronomy, and a new coordination agreement was signed in 2022 with the following provisions which fulfilled conditions of their Generation 2 FCC license. Heading to Boca Chica, equipment was seen being removed from the orbital launch mount. This structure was spotted in the production yard. Near to Starbase is a place called Masseys Range, owned by SpaceX. RGV Aerial Photography posted a tweet saying Masseys Raptor test stand is possible based on the caisson drilling rig being assembled. Musk responded with Masseys gun range is being turned into a rocket test facility. Perfect match. At some point, SpaceX rolled Booster 7 to the launch site for hopefully the final time. Booster 7 was then lifted and placed on the orbital launch mount. Ship 24 was later moved inside the chopsticks. Finally, Starship 24 was lifted and stacked with Booster 7 once again. SpaceX posted this really cool drone footage of Starship 24 being stacked on Booster 7 again. With Ship 24 stacked on Booster 7, SpaceX posted this cool tweet. They said SpaceX had 4 rockets on 4 pads and 2 Dragons on orbit today. As CRS-26 Dragon departed the space station with Crew 5 Dragon still attached to the orbiting lab, Falcon Heavy rolled out to the hangar, 2 Falcon 9s readied for launch, and Ship 24 was stacked onto Booster 7. Finally, let's take a look at the Rodent Beach closures on the Cameron County website. Originally, SpaceX did have a possible closure for today, but that closure was cancelled. So currently, there are a couple more possible closures for this week, with tomorrow, Thursday 12th, and also Friday 13th. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.